The mere fact that I can see you looking at me, that is enough. For now, I have lots of them. Just pick one thing that you can thank God for. I'm not saying you should pray, Lord, give me. Thank God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Father, we bless you. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah. There is a language the heavens sing. There is a chorus the angels shout. I am privileged to join them sing. Today, speak to us.
Amen.
Minister to us, Lord.
Amen.
Father, let there be salvation.
Amen.
Let there be healing, Lord Jesus.
Amen.
Do that which you alone can do.
Amen.
Which you alone, we always do.
Amen.
Father, Blessed be your name.
Hallelujah.
At the end, we will look back and say, yes, of its fruits, we have met with God.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you, Ancient of Days.
Thank you, Lord.
In Jesus' name, we worship.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Once again, clap offering for Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Rosarios, you have to stay there because we're going to be doing some singing, okay? All right. Thank you. God bless you. Hallelujah. Let's sit for now. Amen.
Amen.
I say good morning again to everyone in the house. The Lord bless us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
It's another privilege for me to minister to us. And I thank the Lord for it. I won't take it for granted. I thank the Lord and I honor my husband this morning. Thank you for this privilege. The Lord bless you, sir, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And thank you also for listening. We shall all be blessed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
This morning, by the grace of God, I believe what the Lord wants me to talk about or to admonish us or remind us again is I titled God Most High or Most High God. Amen.
Amen.
Most High God. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
This morning I want to give us some little warning. Amen.
Amen.
And the warning is dare to believe this mighty God. Amen.
Amen.
Do what?
Dare to believe
this mighty, this most high God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You know, every time we talk about, oh, we believe in what God is saying, we believe this, we believe that, oh, it's God, is there. Today, I just want to remind us that of a truth, this God is really the most high God. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Shall we please open our Bibles to Genesis 14, 18 to 19? Genesis 14, 18 to 19. And Melchizedek, king of Salem, brought forth bread and wine, and he was the priest of the Most High God. And he blessed him and said, blessed be Abraham of the Most High God, possessor of heaven and earth. Praise the Lord. I want us to take a prayer from them. I want us to say this morning, blessed be, now put your name. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I found out that when you pray the word of God, is very, very quick. God answers very, very quickly. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So let's bow down our heads this morning and say, blessed be me. Titila your Akishola of the Most High God. And that blessing that you want from the Lord begin to prophesy to your life. Blessed be Titila your Akishola. I am blessed. Of the Most High God. Put that name of the Most High God. Blessed be. Blessed be Titila your Akishola of the Most High God. Of the Most High God, because I serve a Most High God. Blessed be Titilayo Akishola of the Most High God. He is the possessor of heaven and earth. Oh yes, I am blessed when I go out, when I come in, when I sit down, when I eat, when I sleep. Yes, I am blessed. When I speak, when I don't speak, everything I do, lay my hands on, I'm blessed. Blessed be Titilayo Akishola. Blessed be my home. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Ancient of Days. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
What is this name? What does it mean? The Hebrew word for Most High is Elyon. And when you say Most High God, we are saying El Elyon. Amen.
Amen.
That is, he's the supreme being, the highest, none above him, the exalted one. None above him, the exalted one, the highest. The dictionary definition of most means the greatest. The greatest in amount or in degree. Extreme, very, very. And the dictionary definition of high is greater than normal. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
It's greater in quantity, in size, in intensity. So Most High, these two words, they are very big. So it's like saying God is highest. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
God is what? Highest. God is high. God is great. So if God is great, what else? I don't want to use the President of the United States. Now I'm talking of our Prime Minister now. If he says, okay, everyone in Christ Chapel, if he just comes in now, say, everyone in Christ Chapel, you are still believing for your papers, I give to you. Oh, yes. You start hearing the amen. Oh, amen. Amen. That is human. One thing about us, if we tend to believe human, that we tend to really believe God. Bible says that the heart of the kings, they are in the hands of the Lord. He can turn it anywhere he wants. Oh yes, it is possible that he walks here now and says, don't worry, your papers, I'll give it to you. In fact, I will by myself give it to you. I remember that Gio sharing a testimony. He said he went to one of the cities in Nigeria to go and minister to preach the gospel. He was supposed to do his PhD, to defend his PhD. And unknowing to him, his lecturer or his professor went to the man that we oversee the PhD, the everything. He bought a ticket, he went and traveled and said, look, I want you to come and get this boy his PhD. So he gave him the sample of the PhD thesis and so on. The man said, okay, go, I will read it. The professor said, no, I'm sitting here until you read it. It's never done. You give it to him, he will read it. In his own time, he will now say, okay, I'm coming to hear the boy defend his project or his thesis, whatever it is. So the man said, no, I'm not leaving here until you answer me, okay? The man said, okay, I will read it. He read it and said, okay, go ahead, give the boy or give the man his PhD, his degree. The man said, no, it is never done. You have to come and listen so that you can defend this. The man said, are you the highest or I'm the highest? I said, give it to him. He changed. Because of who? Because of God. And that is what God can do. Why not just believe him? Dare to believe God this morning. I have had instances in my life where I dare to believe God and he has never failed. That is why I'm bringing that name that says highest. The most high. Every time we sing it, Jehovah, you are the most high. Highest, Lord, is your name. Do you really know what it means? When we say Jehovah, you are the most high, we are saying Yahweh, you are the highest. There is none above you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So I'm challenging you this morning, whatsoever it is, health, job, your work, whatsoever it is, even life, God is still the highest. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
He is still the highest. So I combine it this morning, I say, yes, Jehovah, highest. I can easily say, God is extremely great. He is very, very, extremely great in every and all aspects. Hallelujah. And one more thing. If there is something called highest, if there is someone called the most high, then definitely there must be someone that is very, very low.
Yeah.
Because where there is high, there is low. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So whatsoever might be troubling you, yes, the Bible says hope deferred makes us sick. But I can assure you, God, his name has not changed. Jehovah Jireh himself, the Lord that sees to situations, he will see to it in Jesus' name.
Amen.
So make sure that you put all those things that is troubling you, put them at the lowest, because God is the highest. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So what did I say the name of God is?
Amen.
Please, I want us to say it together again.
Amen.
Again.
Amen.
Again.
Amen.
Isaiah 14, 13 to 14. That name, so it is such a powerful name. Highest is such a powerful name that even our enemy wanted to be that name. He desired it. He desired it. For thou hast said in thy heart, I will ascend unto heaven. I will exalt my throne above the stars of God. I will sit also upon the mount of the congregation in the sides of the north. Verse 14. I will ascend above the heights of the cloud. I will be like the
Most High.
Don't let it seem as if we are not many here. Like the what?
Most High.
Like the what?
Most High.
That was Satan talking. Say, I will be like the Most High. Nobody can be like the Most High. Nobody. No situation can be like the Most High. No circumstance can be like the Most High. No. No. Because God is the highest, highest. That was the end of it. That was the end of Satan. He said, I will be like the Most High. How dare him? How dare him? He wanted to be like the highest, highest. That shows how great this your God that we serve is. This God that we serve. Begin to think about it. Whatsoever you are, that might be pushing you down or making you to feel anyhow, begin to command it to go under the highest, highest this morning. And it will be so in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Who is this Most High? And what can he do? Or what does he do? Luke 1:35. He is the highest. Number one, he is the highest. I don't know what else to qualify the highest. He is the highest. If we read that Luke 1:35, it said, and the power of the highest shall overshadow thee.
Amen.
Only when the power of the highest overshadows, that is when ordinary can become extraordinary.
Amen.
No woman can conceive without the seed of a man. But when the highest descended upon Mary, the impossibilities became impossible. Or impossibility became possible. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That is God. He is the highest. Number two, his voice is like thunder. 2 Samuel 22:14. Number three, he establishes his children. He does what? He establishes his children, that is God. Psalm 87 verse 5. That is the work of the highest. 2 Samuel 22, 14 says, the Lord thundered from heaven, and the Most High uttered his voice. When he speaks, at times, I'm very, very sure, when we get to heaven, we'll find out. I'm very, very sure, at times, when you just hear some thunder, that must have been God talking. Speaking to somebody's situation and saying it is well. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Psalm 87 verse 5. I said number 3, he establishes his children. And of Zion shall be said, this and that man was born in her, and the highest himself shall establish her. What a wonderful God.
Amen.
So if you think that, oh, that job I've not gotten it, or this I've not, God will establish you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Number 4, he is terrible. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God is what?
Terrible.
There are some versions that say he is awesome. Mm-mm. Awesome is not like terrible. He's a terror. That's what terrible means. He is a terror. He was terrible towards King Pharaoh. He is a terrible God. People don't want to hear that. But God is terrible. That is the truth. Psalm 47 verse 2. Psalm 47 verse 2. For the Lord Most High is what?
Terrible.
Is what?
Terrible.
Is what?
Terrible.
Don't be afraid. He won't be terrible towards you.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. He will be terrible. faithful towards those things that is terrifying you.
Amen.
That is what God will do. God Most High is terrible. He is a great king over all the earth. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He is terrible. Number five, he rules in the affairs of men. In Daniel alone, I think either 7 or 8 times Most High was mentioned. In Daniel alone, in the book of Daniel. He rules in the affairs of men. What is that thing that is like, just, what is it, what will I do? He rules in the affairs of, just believe him, just trust him. He rules. When he says, I will, then he will. When he says, I won't, it's not a man that will change. He will not lie. He rules in the affairs of Daniel 4:17 and 25. He rules in the kingdom of men. He's the one that can say, oh, that brain that is damaged, I'm changing it. He's the one that can say, that can command a wombless woman to have womb. Even he can decide, well, you don't have womb, that doesn't bother me. Let those children be suspended wherever they will be suspended, but you are giving birth. That is God. These two children, IVF, I understand that it's not all the time that it works, and it's very, very expensive. I have a friend that did one. He said the money was, oh my goodness. And people have been saying, oh, don't even go there. That there was somebody that said, that they have done it 5-6 times. It didn't attack, it didn't work. But she did it once because God said it. If God did not say it, it wouldn't have worked. That is the truth. That the world is still being suspended today. Going around the sun is because the Most I said, let it be. But do you know that this same word, God is going to fold it like a mat. So, hallelujah. Only the Most High. Number six, he decrees. Daniel 4:24. He decrees. He says it authoritatively. Not just, you know, it is. No. When he says it, it is coming to pass. I'm challenging you this morning. Oh yeah, we have so many things. Oh, everything can easily work for us here in this part of the world. But I can assure you also, if God decides that boss of yours will fire you, he will. He will. Let us trust God more. And let us believe him more. Amen.
Amen.
Number seven, he made us his saints. That is salvation. He made us his saints. Not the belief of the Catholic. Oh yeah, I was born a Catholic. I know what I'm talking about. You know, when they turn the dead people, their bones about, and they say they want to turn them to be a saint. No, as long as you are a born again Christian, you are a saint. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So when I turn on to you and say, Saint Ruth, yeah, you are a saint. Not only when the person is dead. He made us his saints. That is salvation. So if you are here, you are not yet saved. It is today. You have to be saved in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Daniel 7:18. Number 8. His kingdom is everlasting. Daniel 7:27. Number 9. He judges. Lamentation 3:35. I would like to read that. Lamentation 3:35-38. He judges. He judges. Hallelujah.
Amen.
To turn aside the right of a man before the face of the Most High, yet. To subvert a man in his course, the Lord approved not. Yes? Who is he that said, and it come to pass when the Lord commanded it not? You know, we quote these scriptures at all times. But do you really believe? I was listening to a man of God. He said he met somebody. The man came to him and was saying, Pastor, what do I do now? What do I do now? The pastor said, well, what is the problem? He said, he has been fasting for 40 days. For this job interview that he was about to go for. You are about to go for a job interview. You have been fasting for 40 days, but you don't believe. What are we talking about? So why are you fasting? I consider that punishment. serious, you have just punished yourself. Why are you fasting if you don't believe God? I don't even believe this God will do it. And I've been fasting for 40 days. No, God is not that wicked. God is not even wicked at all. You have fasted, you are praying, believe him, he will do it. And it shall be so in Jesus' name.
Amen.
To subvert a man of his God, God approves not. He doesn't. You just, it's like a judge. Some judges have been bribed to say, oh, work against them. You might be able to pass that sentence, but at times, some judges are being murdered at the step of their houses because of what they have done before. 38, out of the mouth of the Most High proceeded not evil and good? It's a question. This same God that said, I bless you, can as well say, I curse you, if you don't do what he asks you to do. Highest, that is him. He judges. He judges. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. What do you do? What will you have to do for this Most High? Number one, praise him. Praise him. So Christ Chapel, praise God this morning.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Psalm 92 verse 1. Praise him. Praise him. It is a good thing to give thanks unto the Lord and to sing praises unto thy name, O Most High. So that means it is a bad thing not to give thanks unto the Lord. So when you don't give thanks, it's a bad thing. Because if it is good to give thanks, then it is not yet that very good if you don't give thanks. It is a good thing to sing praises unto thy name, O Most High. Number two, pay your vows. Psalm 50 verse 14. Psalm 50 verse 14. Number three, cry to him. Like you have been doing before. Cry to him. What you think he has not done, he will do it. He will do it.
Amen.
God is able to do just what he says he will do. He's gonna fulfill every promise to you. Don't give up on God. Don't give up on God, 'cause he won't give up on you. He's able. Hallelujah. Don't just sing this song. Believe. 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 It's not because of you, but because of God, because of his name. Believe. Number four, bless him. Bless him. Bless him. Bless him. And as I will be rounding off, I want to talk more about believing this God. One of my pastor that I so much admire and love that pastor a lot. He says, what gives value to a word is the credibility of the person that said it. I will say it again. What gives value to a word is the credibility of the person that did what? That said it. What gives credibility or value to a word is the credibility of God, of that person that said it. God said you are healed. Believe. Because it is God that said it. There is value in that word. God said I will heal you. Believe it. Oh, yeah. You can easily bring out your health card and go to the clinic. But why not just trust him more? Believe him. If God says it, then know for sure. Certainly. Surely, I say to you. Verily, I say to you. It will come to pass.
Amen.
Stop doubting. Don't use other means. God, see, the Bible says that The word of the Lord is makes rich and have no sorrow. There are so many ways that people can get riches these days. And I can begin to tell you different kinds of things that people do to make wealth. And you yourself, you know it. The way at which husbands kill their wife for rituals, I don't know if it happens here. The way at which wives kill their husbands for rituals, even their children. Some people join cults. Oh, join us. You will receive power. We'll work out everything for you. Oh yeah, that is just temporary. Don't accept the alternative. God is still God. What does it mean to believe? It is accepting something or someone as true. Is our God true? Is it the truth? Every time we say God is the way, the truth, and the life, so why not just believe it? If he says, I will do it, he will do it. He will do it. He will do it. Daniel was in a foreign land. Eventually, it was even the king that said, don't worry about your papers. I am the paper, so come and work for me. So whatsoever it is that might be troubling, whatsoever it is, God is the highest, highest. He will do it. No matter what the nation says, no matter what that situation is saying, no matter what your examination is saying, God is the highest, highest. He can reverse the irreversible. That is God. Believe him more, sisters. Believe him more, brothers. There is nothing that is impossible for this God to do. We're going to sing that song again.
God is able to do just what he says he will do. He's gonna fulfill every promise to you. Don't give up on God, cause he won't give up on you. He's able. God is able to do just what he says he will do.
Be sure. Salvation, sisters. Only a king's son and daughter can approach the king and say, Daddy, I want this. A servant cannot do that. Be sure of your salvation. Number two, live a holy life, an obedient life. Number three, be a soul winner. It was said this morning. Even the open heavens talking about winning souls. Be a soul winner. A soul winner. Be a soul winner. Be a soul winner. Number one, be sure of your salvation. Two, live a holy life. That is a life of obedience. Three, be a soul winner. Number four, be conscious of the Most High. I want to put it to you this morning, sisters and brothers. It is not over until the Most High says so. It is not the final until the highest say, okay, it is the final. That great apostle, Smith Wigglesworth, he said when his wife died, the revivalist of his days. When his wife died, I said, no, I can't take it. This woman must not go. How do I go with my ministry without this woman? Because he went to minister somewhere. So he was, and he told them, of course, they kept the body for him. So when he came, he went to the room where the body was laid. So he just asked everybody to go out. And he commanded death to release the woman. And the woman came back. The woman said, why are you disturbing me? I don't want to stay. So, he said they discussed. And God told him, leave her. She's finished with her work. I need her back in heaven. And the woman just lay down and went again. It is not the final until the highest says so. It is not over until God says, okay, it is over. So whatsoever it is, whatsoever, I'm a living example. And I'm sure, even you, looking at me, you are living examples. That's why you are still alive today. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The highest is about to surprise us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Even as a church, as families, God is about to surprise us.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
What is it that is so up there that you think, I don't think that is for me. I cannot reach it. No, the highest is above it all. Let him command. Let him say, yes, I will reach it for you. And it shall be so in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Oh, it will soon come, brothers. It will soon come, sisters. I will soon celebrate with you.
Amen.
You will soon celebrate with me.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
But be patient, okay? Because he will do it.
Amen.
He will do it again, God. We'll do it again. He will do it again, yes. He will do it again. Might be it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He will do it again. That is my God for you. By the grace and mercy of God, I prophesy to you.
Amen.
I said the Lord will visit you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Oh, what is he saying? I know what I'm saying because I know my being. By the mercy and grace of God, the representative of the Lord Jesus himself placed his hand upon my head and ordained me as a pastor. And I'm standing on the auction of that man, of that Jesus himself. And I prophesy to every life sitting, hearing me, hearing my voice, this week the Lord will visit you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The Lord himself will visit you.
Amen.
I am standing and I'm decreeing into your life that this week the Lord will give you testimony.
Yeah.
In the name of Jesus, the Lord will give you testimony. The Lord will give you testimony. In the choir, the Lord will give you testimony. This side, the Lord will give you testimony. This side, the Lord will give you testimony. This particular side, the Lord will give you testimony. My husband, the Lord will visit you. In the name of Jesus, I am not going to take it for granted. Enough is enough. I want to hear testimony from everybody. The last righteous brothers prayed. The Lord himself, I was just minding my own business. And it just flashed through my spirit that there is somebody wet in bed. And I just said it as God has said it. Mind you, I cannot do anything for you. Maybe if I have 20 million, I can. But I don't do it. I can't do anything for you. And I just said, well, somebody here, you are bedwetting. The Lord will deliver you. Adults, just 2 weeks ago, that woman called me. When are you going to have this meeting again? I may not be able to come. But I have a testimony. He said, when I get home, I was very angry in my spirit. I said, no, it is enough. And God, since then, up to now, that child stopped bedwetting. Don't believe me, but believe the God that I serve. And I'm decree to you once again, the Lord will visit you.
Amen.
Because I know very well, I believe. I can put my hand on my chest like this because I believe the God has said. And I know this very week the Lord will visit all of us. You will come and share testimony in the name of Jesus. You will share testimonies in the name of Jesus. You will say, oh, come and see what the Lord has done for me. Come and see what the Lord is good. Oh, yeah. Come and see the Lord is good. I'm telling you. Oh, you don't know anything, no?
Yeah.
I am so charged up this morning because I know woman. I know the God I am serving. My father in the Lord, that is you. He said this year, lots of surprises.
Yeah.
What type of surprises do you want?
Like that one.
Thank you, my mommy. What type of surprises do you want? Begin to declare it. What type of surprises do you want? Begin to declare it. Whatever surprises you want for your life, for your home, for your grandchildren, for your job, begin to declare it. Say this week, oh, me, Titila, you are Kishola. Oh, yes. Something good is coming my way. Ah, oh, yes. Something wonderful is coming my way. I don't care what the world is saying. I don't care what Canada or Bali is saying. Something wonderful is coming my way. In the name of Jesus, my own surprise, it must start just this week, if not today. In the name of Jesus, today. Yes, begin to command the womb of the morning. Begin to say, yes, that professor will favor me. I may not do well in that exam, but that professor will favor me. In the name of Jesus, begin to command the womb of the morning. Begin to say, yes, it is well with my children. In the name of Jesus, thank you, Father. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
One way or the other, we are all children of somebody. Amen?
Amen.
We are what?
Children of somebody.
Isaiah 65:23, please. Want to use that to pray as I round up now? Isaiah 65:23. Oh, thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. It is not a mistake. I know for sure. It is not a mistake. These days, Daddy Gio, he doesn't really pray for so many people again during ordination. But I was privileged that he ordained me himself. He placed his hand on me. And I am standing under that option this morning. This morning is not tomorrow. This morning, God is visiting us. In this class, Apollo, enough is enough of stagnation. In this place, it is ended. It is done. It is testimony to the Lord in the name of Jesus. They shall not labor in vain. It is the word of the Lord. They shall not labor in vain. It is enough. It is enough. You are going out of this place favored.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
You are not living the way you came.
Amen.
Whatsoever is bothering you, they shall not labor in vain.
Amen.
No man, no woman, no child here, sitting down here, even people that are not here, they shall not labor in vain.
Amen.
Nor bring forth for trouble.
Amen.
Every woman here, begin to pray for that child. Say, my child, say, bring forth. That is, we are not going to give birth for trouble. Mm-mm. Our children, they have come to this land. Even the children that are abroad, we have prayed for them, prophesied for them. My children, they are not for trouble. They are not for calamity. Begin to pray in the name. Even if you are yet to be married, begin to pray for your future. Yes, my children, I did not bring them forth for trouble. In the name of Jesus. Yes, pray in the name of Jesus. For they are the seed of the blessed of the Lord. How many blessed do I have here? You are blessed, yes. They are your seed. Begin to prophesy unto them. Bless them, yes. And their offspring with them. That is your grandchildren. They are blessed. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Highest, highest. Highest, highest. We thank you. Most high God. Thank you, Ancient of Days. Thank you, Father. Blessed be your name. We are living here rejoicing.
Amen.
We are living here rejoicing.
Amen.
We are living here rejoicing.
Amen.
The Lord is taking us to our Rehoboth. In the name of Jesus. The Lord is making space for us. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, mighty God. Thank you, mighty God. Thank you, mighty God. Thank you, mighty God. Father, we worship you. Jehovah, we bless your name. Ah, Baba. This morning, Lord, we come before you. Oluwa, you are the most high God. Olorun Oga Ogbo. You are the most high God. The one that is highest, highest. No one is above you. Father, whatsoever that thing that might have been disturbing us, disturbing your sons, disturbing your daughters, Father, we ask King of Glory, just like you sit upon the circles of the earth, and even this world, we are like grasshoppers, and your feet is upon this earth. Father, step to these situations in the name of Jesus. We speak and we prophesy. This very day, as from now on, favor is ours in the name of Jesus. We shall go out with favor. Sit with favor, sleep with favor, eat with favor, stand with favor, drive with favor, in the name of Jesus. Father, we are reaching our real boots. You are making space for us, in the name of Jesus. Our children, they will not be for trouble. They will not be for calamity, in the name of Jesus. Father, we rebuke anything called stagnation, in the name of Jesus. Lord, this week, let testimonies flow in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Ancient of Days. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen. Holy is your word that I've hidden in my heart. Holy is your word that was there from the start. And it's sharp like a sword.